Hi guys, welcome back. TerraFirmaCraft with me, Sid, and I have been doing quite a little bit of work off camera. Between episodes, I have gone and found not one, not two, but three gold mines. And some, oh yeah, I got accosted by a skeleton, so the mace was on the hotbar. So yeah, I have been all over the shop doing things, running around, finding ores, just generally trying to progress a little bit, so, you know, get some of the off-camera work done. So let me show you. For starters, I've now got a whole buttload of coal, a whole buttload of gold, some more charcoal. I did another fire pit. Rich magnetite, or magnesite. I got some cassiterite. What else did we get? Anything in hiding in there? No, that was just cheese and stuff. So the other thing I found while I was out, apart from some kaolinite, which we need to grind up, is this sylvite. And I should have actually been down at the house for this, because that's where my grindstone is. But sylvite is fertilizer. It's the first time I come across it. Now, what I didn't find, unfortunately, was any nickel. Can't remember the name of the ore now off the top of my head. And I didn't come across any silver. So I'm still hunting for that. So, you know, lots of running around, finding things. I have bred a whole load of animals. I need to really move them before they pop, because they'll probably just explode out that pen. But this fertilizer, I wanted to have a little bash at. So let me just... I'm going to need to make a new handstone soon. But this fertilizer, basically, what you can do with it, apparently... And I don't need it... Oops. I may not need it, but I don't necessarily want to throw it on the ground. I'm going to need my hoe, and I'm going to need a little bit of dirt. Not sand, dirt. Let me just have some quartzite dirt. I'm only going to try, I want to try this out, because this I've not used before. Now this is not obviously like bone meal. So if we change the mode, you can see the nutrients in this soil are more or less recovered from last season's growing. That one's a little bit low. If I were to put that down and hoe it, it's got absolutely zero nutrients. Now what I want to know is if I use this fertilizer on it, which probably would have been made more sense if I did that, it appears to have done nothing. Now if I put it there, no, it's apparently this refreshes the nutrients. Whoa. Yeah, that's done something there. It's not really done a lot there. So I want to grind that all up and just see, oh, ouch, what it actually achieves. Right, let me stick some more of you in, and I'm going to start the old grinding, and I'll be back with you in a mo, because I'm intrigued. Call me intrigued, so to speak. Okay, I've got a whole load more, so let's see. Oh, yeah, that has actually... replenished the nutrients in this soil pretty good. I am happy it's fertilized, so that is, I don't know whether that's going to recover the mixed nutrients, but it's got that fertilizer in it. Yeah, so that's what I want to, basically what I want to see is if it's going to be possible for me to make a more structured farm than, let me get rid of that because that's distracting, than we had previously, because, you know, at the moment this is messy, and what I would actually like to try and do is use the water source blocks to kind of, when I'm going to, blah blah blah, spit it out, John. We'll get there eventually. What I want to do is start to build some farm areas over near the castle, and obviously this land again will be quite ugly, but if I think if I, well, we can find out, can't we? If I, let's just find a little friendly bit of ground where I'm possibly not going to do much farming. So if I take out that and that, usual source block mechanic supply. So I can kind of straighten, I can come in, I can then put the old dirt back down. Now that's obviously going to be poor, whereas that's not fully formed. So what I want to do is try and move the water source blocks into the farm so I can get a farm that works a little bit more friendly. That's for another day, obviously. I'm not going to be doing that. Don't want to be doing that today. It takes a while to dig that. Oh, and you don't get the dirt back. How splendid. Well, I'll take these up. I'll take these out. Why are you not source blocked properly now? Okay, no problem. We will... oh, gravel. We will live with that errors and place that back. And but until I get a red steel bucket, I can't basically do anything with water. I'm stuck to whatever water source blocks I've got, so I need to tidy this up and make the farm areas a little bit more sensible. So I'll experiment with that anyway, off the thing. Let me just... I've got an itch on my leg, and I'm driving me insane. So what I need is I need to make a whole load of mortar, because one of the things I've been doing between episodes, I did find a spider had spawned in here the other day. So I'm a little bit wary now when I walk in. Somewhereabouts I should have that shale, dolomite. I should have a whole load of dolomite, and if I take about half of that for fluxing. Oh, I suppose we better sleep. I need to make a whole load more. What we got there? 29 out. Yeah, let's get that out before it goes off. Where are we? Here, did it chomp. Right, what was I doing? Flux. So, I'll borrow that hammer. And we'll stick the dolomite in there, and we'll get 64 flux. That should be good. It's nice building with dolomite, because it means I've got the materials for flux on hand. So the first thing I'm going to need to do is make up a whole load of mortar. Got the sand, got the bucket, got the flux. I'm also probably going to need to cook up a little bit of glass, and then we can get on and start building in the next tier of the castle. I'm just being a bit phobic there. So, as before, it's the usual thing. We go bucket of water and a sand and a flux. What I would give for a tinker's construct crafting station right now, rather than this thing. So I'm going to make a bunch of concrete. I'm going to go and grab my chisel. Ooh, I'm going to throw a bucket in the lake. I am going to grab a chisel and probably just a stone hammer for making the bricks, and I will be right back with you. Right, I've got a bunch of concrete. I've also brought some sand up, and the reason for that is I want some glass, as I say, to make some windows. And the easiest way is probably going to be fire up this bad boy, so we'll just give it a little start there. Let's try... get rid of you out of my life. Stick another coal in, and let's just do that. It's obviously much faster than using the fire pit to do the old glass. In the same way that this is much faster to cook food. Now, one of the things that's been suggested in the comments, and I will be doing that in the castle, is there will be a kitchen, and we will be actually getting into cooking rather than just eating raw things, because I do need to increase my cooking skill. But come on, you should. There we go. bang, 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 and obviously a lot faster. That should warm up fairly quickly. So I'm going to make enough glass to make, you know, quite a few panes. Yeah, and once we've got that done, we can get on, get them bricks made, and get on and continue on with the castle a little bit. Because I've got some plans for this bad boy. So I'll be back once we've got all the glass done. Right, we've got a bunch of glass. We've got a bunch of concrete. What we don't have is a bunch of bricks. Now, I'm okay for shale. I've got a little bit of dolomite and shale in smooth stone. I can always go and get more of that. And I've got a few bricks of these. But what I need is some dolomite bricks. 64 of those. Should I do... Hang on. I'm trying to remember which way around this goes. Yeah, I'm just going to... We got what we got? Dolomite. Should have more dolomite over here. 2, 3, 4. And I need to shed some stuff, don't I? Gravel. 5. So if I brickerize all of those, hopefully there'll be enough durability left in this chisel. We can make a stack of dolomite bricks. Amazing how this doesn't go very far at all. But that gives us plenty of that. We'll put those away. We will grab those and those. So one plan I have is to go sleep quickly. Amazing, that night time just comes around on you so fast. Eat, sleep, rave, repeat. Sorry, it's an advert that I've been seeing quite a lot on the UK TV recently for Ibiza, and it's just a really simple song that goes eat, sleep, rave, repeat, eat, sleep, rave, repeat, and I just can't get it out of my head. You know the kind of thing. All right, there we go. So what we are going to do in the castle is we're going to work on this second floor and then work on getting a roof onto this third floor, which is going to be just above this level. Now we've got the exit here, and this thing here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I think we'll take out these bricks for starters. And this brick here and here. Grab a bit of that action. Go 1, 2, 3, and we'll just stick a bit of shale in just for variation. And then, just using these dolomite bricks, I'll go down and get those in a moment. We're just going to have a little balcony area, if you like, coming out here. Now keeping abreast with generic, but he's running quite a cool looking version of the of TFC. It's the latest build, which I know apparently has some issues. Mode, stair mode, I think, and then bonk, 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 and bonk. And then maybe we'll stick a shale in there, just for good measure, because I've got it in my inventory. We'll stick that in there, and we'll change you to slab mode. And that can go fairly simply like that. Yeah, that works for me. Now, the other thing I want to do, let me just go and see if I've got any, what I've got in the chest. Show me what I've got. I should have tons of, yes, smooth quartzite. So this is a very dark, dingy, drab kind of structure. Maybe I should just try this on one first, actually. So, what I am thinking is in detail mode. Well, let me change to slab mode first. And can you not slab that? Oh, you swine. Huh. Nope, you can't slab it. Wonderful. I didn't really want to have to... Oh, of course, you need a hammer. Right, I'm just being an idiot there. So if I take that back two that way, that one back two that way, and then just come out this side and go... One, two, and you can't shift and do that. So we can bring that back. And similarly... One, two, one, two. I'm definitely going to have to build a new chisel before the end of this episode. One, two, one, two. So that's a very basic wall. But obviously we can do an awful lot more than that. So what I am thinking is we leave... Maybe take all of that out on that side. This is awkward as hell when you're working. And similarly on that side. And then we go one... One, and then that comes in like, hang on, one, oh god, what am I doing here? Yeah, that's right. So what I'm trying to get is kind of a banister like affair if I just run through so you can kind of get a feel for the shape I'm going for. As I say, I am definitely going to have to build another shift and do this though, that's a pain in the bum. I'm probably going to have to make wood scaffolding to get to the right eye level. But we run this through, and the slab mode obviously means I have to take out less. So do the same here. All the way through. I think there's still going to be a little bit to take out. There. I'm definitely going to need another chisel. And we can repeat that. On both sides. Let me just come around here. Yeah, there's ow. Though we've definitely got problems already. I'm going to have to do that again. I'm going to get that done. I'm going to just create a bit of scaffold out of something. And I'll be back with you in a moment. Okay, I've been chiseling for a while. And I keep cocking up a block. But I remember there's a mechanic in TerraFirmaCraft. If I can get the little bugger. Don't know whether I've got his food as well. But I need a squid. Squids in TFC are tiny. You get a little bit of raw calamari from them, which is protein. It's really handy. If you're near water, it's not a bad source of starting food. Just trying to see if I can see any more down here. But more importantly, they drop ink, just like squids in normal squids in Minecraft. The only difference is they're not quite so huge. They're just as derpy. You can see loads down there. I don't want to go down there, however. Anyway, I need to just get back to the thing, and hopefully I've got a little bit of sugar cane left, so I will head over there and I will see you in a moment. Excellent to have. So we create paper exactly the same as you do normally in Minecraft. We can put that into ink sac and we get marking, 16 markings per ink sac, so it's fairly cost efficient. And then you combine the two to create a blueprint. Let's head up to the castle. So the way a blueprint works is once you've built a detail block, and I completely forgot about this, I've been doing this the hard way, all the way down to this balcony thing, and that's the word I was looking for, balcony. And I kept on cocking up the last one, so I built all of these. I just put this temporary structure in place and it made it easier to see from eye level. But if I take my blueprint and right click on there, and I'll call it balcony, done. So that is a balcony blueprint. Not so special about that, you may say. Well, place down your block, get a hammer, and have I not got a hammer? Looks like my hammer broke. So we'll just do another one. I can never remember whether it's two off the top or one. I tend to just use wooden hammers, stone hammers for this, because they wear out so damn fast. It's up. What's going on here? There's something weird going on with my inventory. Okay, and then what you do is you change it and detail the block, and then you just bang. The blueprint is used up, unfortunately, because it's, you obviously overlay it, but it is pretty damn quick way of doing the detail. Now, I don't know why these two have done that, but fortunately they do have an option here, which is to make two more blueprints. We can hammer you out. We can hammer you out, and we can go bonk. Just call it one. Doesn't really matter. And let's just try that again. See whether we can detail mode. And no, it's done it exactly. It must just be the fact it's connecting to that wall. Okay, not a problem. Detail mode, let me get a blueprint, bang, done, bang. You can see the durability is taken off of the thing. I've had to make a steel chisel because this was taking so much durability off. And that is essentially what I wanted to do with this little kind of balcony area. It just adds a different colour. We get the white in there, which kind of offsets it. And what we can do is take all of this stuff out here. And hopefully the grass will grow back before long. And that gives us quite a nice detailed balcony. Now, I'm aware there is a risk with these detailed blocks that we could corrupt the chunk. And please be reassured that I do back up my saves every night. So yeah, I've got a 1 terabyte NAS, a 4 terabyte NAS hiding under the desk here. Give me some of that oak. Yeah, 4 terabyte NAS hiding under the desk, and you know that means that I'm reasonably secure. Should my word, I didn't pick that wood up, did I? So I need to get a roof on this. That's my next thing. It's probably going to be the last thing I get done today. There we go. Not as much as I'd like to, because I spent far too long doing that. So the next thing I'm going to do is just get up on top, put another layer of bricks on, and I will be right back with you. Alright, I basically went mad stabbing torches around for the time being, because I've got to work out a lighting plan for in here. But I've got a roof on, which is obviously, I say a roof, I've got a flat layer of chestnut logs. But that's a start, shall we say. We've got my little balcony, that's all nice and sexy. I still don't like that. And the fact that I did make a little light cock up there and there, which is a bit unfortunate, especially seeing as, oh, that's a copy of that, of course, that's why I only made a cock up there. Now, there is one thing I want to try, and that is, this roof is quite a large one, so I want to put a brace running across the middle here, and I don't want to do it in chestnut, so I've got some hickory, which I think might look quite nice. I also need to eat and drink, because I've just noticed my hunger is not looking overly good. It's the danger of this game: when you start concentrating on something, then you do run the risk of forgetting and dying of starvation. So what I am thinking now, this is going to be awkward, because I need to give myself a little bit of leeway. But I want to kind of get it... This is going to be really awkward, in fact. Hang on. So if I go here with a solid block and then just run across... So there's a different colour for starters. So that's a bit of a contrast colour, so to speak. And from here I'm going to drop a chandelier. But I need to make it look a little bit more than just this solid beam. Now, buttons don't work anymore, so I've got to know how you make those, if you can at all. So I can't use that particular trick to... hickory it up, I suppose. I can't say spruce it up, because obviously it's not spruce, it's hickory. Now I suppose if I do that, I don't want to come too far down either, because that's going to look silly if I do that. If I do that, and oh dear, it's getting on to night time. Let me just go in there, sleep off the night before it becomes a problem. The lighting is starting to make me nervous in there now, though, because if I don't get the lighting in there right, then it is going to be A, too dark, which, you know, is not good. Just for in terms of, yeah, stuff managed to spawn. Wonderful. Now, did it manage to spawn inside here? I'm armed with my mace, because I heard a skelly bob earlier. Not in here when I was harvesting some more of this, and it wasn't a nice. Wasn't nice. Let's just say it wasn't nice. I can use this because I'm quite happy to wear out this pick a little bit. Okay, so if I chop you out, and then similarly, this was the same at this side. Just temporarily. And then I can, this is where, as I say, it becomes a little bit convoluted. So I want you to be kind of like that. It's not going to be exactly the way I would have liked it, because I don't think it's going to be possible given the constraints of the TerraFirmaCraft mod to do the... I think it's going to be very difficult, shall we say, to do this, because, you know, you have to... faff around, get the angles right, get all that stuff going the way you want it. So you can see we've got that, and then if I do the same again here, like that, that kind of gives you a feeling of that, I think, that whatever, you know, the goings on. And if I do the same over here, let me just... where's my crappy axe there? I say crappy axe, it's not that crappy, but, you know. Compared to the new one, it's not brilliant. I've done that the wrong way around. Wonderful. Fortunately, I've got hickory to spare. That's better. So that gives you that going on. Now, what we can do then is I can go and change to slab mode. And go 1, 2, 1, 2. And then similarly over here. 1, 2. 1, 2, and then we go 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. I'm just trying to get a curve going on here. 3, 1, 2, 3, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4. So that goes down to half slab. Now I'm thinking whether we can actually get this down. If I go down to 4 here, 1, 2, 3, and then 4, and then we take this down to 2. That might work better. And this one down there, and then we'll get the crap axe, and we can just take this support work out. Now the last thing I'll need to do in here, and I'm not going to do it today because I haven't really got a firm plan for how I want to do it, is the chandelier. And that kind of gives it an impression of a brace going on there. Now, I suppose what I could do, just to balance this up even further, would be to go from here. And then we can get this thing going again, back into stair mode, like that. And that was... God, that's not what I wanted to do. Mode 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then the only thing I need to do is that stair on the other side, just to get the brace going. Which should be pretty straightforward, I think. And again, this has not necessarily got any rhyme or reason to the design. I'm just kind of, sometimes you have a really solid, and sometimes you cock up right royally. Right, let's try that again. I've got four pieces left before I have to go running off to... That should be it. Right, let's put that down. We can go and replace that. Chop this out. And that is almost this section done. So that kind of joins in and merges in, so that buttresses up to that wall. I could have gone and dropped it down at that side so it arched over, but I don't know. I quite like that. I think that works reasonably well. The lighting, as I say, is going to be an issue. We need to make sure this is as... I don't think it's ever going to be totally spawn-proof. It's just going to be too much to do. I also need to work out where my stairs are going to go, and I may spiral up here. Now the final thing that I want to just have a look at is some upstairs windows. And let's have a look. Wood. Stone. God only knows. Conglomerate rock. I can't remember where I got that from. Get rid of you. Right, somewhere about. I knew I had a pain. 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That should be enough glass to keep me going for a long time. So what I was thinking here is probably here. You know what I didn't do? There's a design theme going throughout and we need to stick to it. So we'll take that and that. I'll just go and grab that little bit of yeah, that works. And then probably there as well, just keep the lines flowing. And possibly there, well, not sure about there, because that's going to be castle wall. So it was here. And then we take you out, and we pop a bit of that in, we take that out, pop a bit of that in, and you got nothing on that bit. And maybe, I don't know, it's difficult decision. Let's put one there or not. I think not. And that is a fortification wall. So yeah, we're getting some progress on the castle, and obviously we're making some progress on moving on to black steel, which is the next which is the next tier of metals. But it's slow going, and this is going to probably have one more floor before we start tapering into the tower that's going to go up there. So, yeah, I think that kind of works reasonably well, and we'll continue on next time. But until then, thank you very much for watching, guys, and I will see you soon. Bye for now.